Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. We thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky. Tonight I will be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of June. So as always, sit back, buckle in, and let's see what's really out there. As always, this month we will be visiting some very prominent deep sky objects in the month of June, and the first one is Messier 4. If spring is galaxy season, then summer belongs to the globular star clusters. One of the best examples of a summer globular cluster is Messier 4, a bright globular cluster that is easily found about midway between the stars Antares and Alnaeus in Scorpius. This southern constellation doesn't rise very high from northern latitudes, but you'll still be able to get a great view of Messier 4. If you live under reasonably dark skies, you should be able to spot Messier 4 as a faint, fuzzy patch through a pair of binoculars. Midsize and large scopes can provide a spectacular view of this Messier object. So that was Messier 4, now we're going to move right on to Messier 5. Messier 5 is one of the best globular clusters in the night sky. You can find it nearly 8 degrees to the southwest of Alpha Serpentis. Visible in binoculars and telescopes, Messier 5 appears slightly oval at a lower power, with a halo that extends about twice as far as the core itself. Increasing the magnitude to around 80 times will allow you to resolve some of the individual stars, while a larger scope and higher magnification will also show chains of stars snaking their way out from the center. Next on our list of deep sky objects is Messier 12. Messier 12 appears as a fairly bright nebulous patch through binoculars, while through a small telescope it appears large, uniformly gray, and misty, but with some resolution with a bird of vision. As with other globulars, Messier 12 has chains of stars, but also be on the lookout for dark gaps and patches across the face of the cluster. So before we visit a few other deep sky objects, let's bring this tour a little bit closer to home and see what the moon and the planets are up to. The evening sky is totally devoid of planets this month. Saturn is the first to rise and is well placed for observation in the hours after midnight. Look out for a waning gibbous moon close by on June 18th. Next, over the horizon is distant Neptune, which rises about 75 minutes after Saturn, with both Jupiter and Mars following shortly after. Mars and Jupiter form a close binocular pair at the start of the month, but then slowly start to drift apart. Jupiter is unmissable and glows at a magnitude negative 2.3, but Mars remains relatively faint at a magnitude of 0.6. The last quarter moon passes Jupiter and Mars on the 21st and the 22nd. Next up is faint Uranus, but it will still be low over the horizon when the sky starts to brighten. Venus also rises hours after the sun, but it is much brighter than Uranus and can be seen shining brilliantly in the twilight. As for Mercury, it edges away from the sun and becomes visible 20 to 30 minutes before sunrise, around the 10th and onward. A thin crescent moon appears to the left of Venus on the 26th, and then a little left of Mercury the following morning. Lastly, the moon itself turns full on the 14th and new on the 29th. Okay, so next up on our list is not a cluster, but rather a somewhat difficult double star to observe. But when properly observing, it can be a treat to see through a telescope. Xi Bootis. You'll need a magnification of close to 100 times to split this star. It's a pretty double, with a creamy pale gold primary and a coppery or rosy colored companion. This is a true binary star system, with the two stars taking 151 years to orbit one another. From our vantage point, the pair are now drawing closer together and will be at their closest in 2066. Scorpius is home to another globular cluster other than Messier 4, and this is Messier 80. Messier 80 is relatively easy to find. It's located between Sigma and Delta Scorpii and lies within the same binocular field of view as both stars. Messier 80 is bright enough to be detected with binoculars, but you won't see anything more than a tiny misty patch. Telescopes will show a bright compact core that requires a larger scope to resolve. Look out for a magnitude 8.5 star to the northeast and just barely beyond the outer edges of the cluster. All right, well, that is it for our tour of the night sky. We thank you so much for tuning in this month of June. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. And if you've actually been able to view any of these globular clusters in the night sky, we would love to hear that as well. Thank you so much again for tuning in, and we hope to see you next time. Clear skies.